Good morning, students. I'm Narasim as faculty in Target High School. You know very well, all of you. Yes, today I sent the question paper. So regarding probability chapter, students, in slip test, this is the question paper. Yes, in this question paper, 10 problems are there. 10 into 2, 20 marks, students. Now I explain this problem solution, students, in this video. So first problem, observe all of you. First Roman, solve all following sums. Okay, first one, observe carefully. A bag contains 5 black, 7 red and 3 white balls. A ball is drawn from the bag at random. Find the probability that the ball is drawn. So red, black or white, next not black, students. So first in a bag, observe carefully, going to solution. So in a bag, number of black balls equal to, how many are there? 5 black balls. Next one, number of red balls equal to 7. Next, number of white balls equal to, how many white balls are there? 3. So here total number of balls equal to, total here 15 balls. So in that, we know that probability of an event, therefore probability of an event equal to number of favorable outcomes by total number of possible outcomes. So simply we express as P of E equal to N of E by N of S, students. Right, go for first one, what they given. So number one here, so probability of red ball equal to how many red balls are there here? 7 red balls. Total balls 15. That is 7 by 15 is the solution. Okay, right. Comes to second one. Probability of black or white balls equal to, black or white means both taken, students. Here, so black balls equal to 5 and white balls equal to 3. 5 plus 3 how much? 8. So that is favorable outcomes equal to 8. Total outcomes equal to 15. So 8 by 15 is the solution. Right. And go for third one, students. What he asked? Probability of black ball only. So first we find probability of black, then after not black. So probability of black equal to, so black balls 5 only. So that is 5 by 15. So we know that formula, probability of event plus probability of not event equal to 1. So probability of black here given. Probability of not black is denoted by B dash. So like this taken, students. Probability of B dash equal to, or not B equal to, 1 minus P of B. It becomes 1 minus P of B value 5 by, or we have taken 5 ones, 5 threes, isn't it? So we have taken 1 minus of 1 by 3. 1 by 3. So then that implies 3 1 is 3. So 2 by 3 is the solution. 2 by 3 is the solution. This is solution of first problem, students. Okay, all of you understood, I thought. Right. Go for second problem. Second problem. Two unbiased coins are tossed simultaneously. Find the probability of getting two heads, at least one head, at most one head, no head, and also one tail. No head and also one tail. So If two unbiased coins are tossed simultaneously, so directly simply, students, I take here two coins are tossed simultaneously. okay, simultaneously. Okay, students, right. So possible outcomes, S equal to. So that is head, 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 tail, tail, head, tail, 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 tail. Okay, these are the possible outcomes. Total outcomes, N of S equal to 4 sprints. N of S equal to 4. Okay, here what they given, observe. First one, let A be, the getting two heads, event of two heads, event of two heads. So then observe carefully here, let A be the event of getting two heads. Okay, that is N of A equal to. So how many getting two heads? Two heads, how many of them here? One only. So N of A equal to 1. N of A equal to 1. So then therefore probability of P of A equal to N of A by N of S. P of A equal to N of A by N of S. It becomes 1 by N of S value 4 friends. So 1 by 4. And second one, let P be the event of getting at least one head. So here also information, right, friends. Then here at least one head means at least one or more. How many of them here? 3 is there. So that is N of B. Next one, N of B equal to 3. Therefore, P of B equal to N of B by N of S. It becomes N of B value. How much here? 3. So 3 by 4 friends. 3 by 4. Next, third one. Say here also, friends. Let C be the event of getting at most one head taken, friends. So at most one head, that implies at most one head means one or below. How many of them? 1, 2, 3. So that is 2 tails also, it is no heads. So that is 3. N of C equal to 3, friends. Therefore, it implies P of C equal to N of C by N of S. At least one head, at most one head. Both are same here result. So that is 3 by 4. And comes to fourth one. No head. Probability of no head means only tail. Here also, let D be the getting event. Okay? Then N of D equal to. So no head means only tails. N of D equal to 1. Therefore, probability of D equal to N of D by N of S. So it becomes 1 by 4. And finally, fifth one. What he asked? Only one tail. How many of them? 2 only, students. Next, let E be the event of getting only one tail. So then that implies N of E equal to 2 chances. Okay, so probability of E equal to N of E by N of S, it becomes 2 by 4. So finally it becomes 1 by 2 is the solution. This is the solution of second problem, students. Right, observe third problem, students. The king, queen and jack of clubs are removed from a deck of 52 playing cards and well shuffled. One card is selected from the remaining cards. Find the probability of getting a heart, a king, a club, the 10 of hearts. Here, first observe carefully, students, all of you. Solution given. In a deck of playing cards, total number of playing cards equal to 52. In that, the king, queen and jack of clubs are removed from the deck of playing cards. So here, king, queen and jack of hearts. removed or removed from the deck, from the deck of playing cards, from the deck of playing cards, from the deck of playing cards. Therefore, total number of cards n of s equal to 52 minus 3, it becomes 49. 49, is it? Right. So first one, in that, subject carefully what they given. One card is selected from the remaining cards. So number one, find the probability of getting a hearts. So total here, total number of hearts cards equal to 13. In that, three cards are removed. Therefore, probability of hearts, equal to, so 13, in 13 three cards are removed, means remaining are 10 cards. Favorable outcomes equal to 10. Total number of outcomes equal to 49. 10 by 49. Here probability of event equal to n of e by n of s taken students. N of e by n of s. Okay, right. Probability of outcomes equal to 10 by 49. Next, second one. What they given? Probability of a king. So probability of a king equal to, so total king cards in a deck of playing cards are 4 is there. 4 cards are there, right? In that, the hearts of king is removed. So remaining are 3 cards only. That is 3 by 49. Right. Next, to go for third problem, students. What he was? Probability of a club cards. So in club cards, how many in a deck of playing cards, club cards are 13 is there. So favorable outcomes equal to 13, total outcomes equal to 49. So 49. Right. Next, fourth one. 10 of hearts. Total hearts card equal to 13. In that, 3 cards are removed. So remaining are 10. In that, so 10 numbered card is also there. It is how many chances? Only one chance. So that is probability of 10 of hearts. 10 of hearts equal to one chance. That is 1 by 49. 1 by 49. This is the result of your third problem, students. Okay? Right. Next, go for fourth one. Cards are numbered 1, 2, 3 and so on, 17 are put in a box and mixed thoroughly. One person draws a card from the box. Find the probability that the number on the card is odd number, a prime number, divisible by 3, and 2, both. 3 and 2, both, students. Right. Solution given. Numbers are. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 17, students. So total number of numbers, let me consider n of s equal to here 17. Okay? Right. So what we find, observe, students? Odd numbers. So go for first one. Let A be the event of getting odd numbers. So how many of them are the students? N of E equal to getting odd numbers. Which are the odd numbers? That is, subject carefully, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, and also 13, 15, 7. Okay, that is how many? 9 is there. N of E equal to 9, friends. So probability of event, P of E equal to, or we are given here, P of A equal to N of A by N of S. So it becomes N of A value 9 by 17. 9/17. That is the first one, students. And go for second. Let B be the event of getting prime numbers. Getting prime numbers. That is, which are the prime numbers? Okay, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17. These are the prime numbers, friends. How many of them? 7 are there. So that is n of b equal to 7. Then probability of event equal to n of b by n of s. So it becomes n of b value 7/17. 7/17. Yes, divisible by 3. And third one. Observe carefully. Let c be the event of getting a divisible by 3 or. So divisible by 3. 3 1 is 3. 3 2 is 6. 3 3 is 9. 3 4 is 12. 3 5 is 15. Okay. So these are the values, friends. So then here n of c equal to 5. Therefore probability of c equal to 5 by 17. Next, go for fourth problem, students. Divisible by 3 and 2 both. Okay, 3 and 2 both. So here, let D be the event of getting a divisible by 3 and 2 both. 3 and 2 both means, what is the LCM? 3 to the 6 value, students. Getting 6 multiples of. How many? Which are the 6 multiples? 6 1 is 6, 6 2 is 12. So therefore, n of d equal to 2, students. N of d equal to 2. Okay? Then probability of d equal to n of d by n of s. So it becomes 2 by 17. That is the results of fourth problem, students. Okay? Right. Next, fifth one, observe. A letter is chosen at random from the letters of the word assassination. Find the probability that the letter chosen is a vowel and also a consonant, students. So observe carefully. Go for fifth problem. A letter is chosen at a random from the letters of the word. Solution given, the word is. Yes, what they given, observe, friends? Assassination. Okay, total letters or total number of letters, whatever, total letters, we have taken n of s equal to. So here observe, students, total letters taken here, s four times is there, here three times is there, don't take 12, total letters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 11, 12, 13, okay? So here, which are the letters, this is one way or other way. Okay, we are taking observe here, students. Possible outcomes. S equal to. Here, which are the letters observe? A, how many times observe? 1, 2, 3 times is there. So, we can express one time only. S, 4 times is there. Repeat, S. Next, I, 2 times. A, 3 times. S, 4 times. Okay, and also I also, how many times? 2 times is there. Next, T, which are the letters T? Next, O, and also L. Okay, yes, here n of s equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. n of s equal to 6, right? Problem number 1. Which are the vowels? How many vowels are there here? A, E, I, O, U. 3 vowels are there. So first one, students, of the probability of vowel spreads. Let A be the letters of the event of getting vowels. That is, which are the vowels here? A, I, O. Only 3 vowels. That is, n of A equal to 3. So here, therefore, probability of A equal to n of A by n of S. So it becomes n of A 3, n of S total how many? 6. So it becomes 1 by 2. Next, the second one. Let B be the event of getting consonants. Getting of consonants. That is, which are the consonants here? That is S, T, N. S, T, N. Okay? So then that implies N of B equal to 3. So P of B equal to N of B by N of S. So it becomes 3 by 6. So strike graphing becomes 1 by 2. This is the solution of fifth problem, students. Okay? I thought all of you understood. Right. Go for it. Next one. Sixth problem. A game consists of tossing a 1 rupee coin 3 times and noting its outcome each time. Hanif wins if all the tosses give the same result. Hanif wins all the tosses give the same result. Means 3 heads, 3 tails. And that is 3 heads or 3 tails. And losses otherwise. So losses means remaining way, students. Right. Calculate the probability that Hanif will lose the game. Observe carefully, students. Right. Sixth one. Observe, students. A coin tossed 3 times. A coin tossed 3 times. So, total number of outcomes. N of S equal to 2Q. So, it becomes 8, students. So, here, which are the outcomes? Equal to S equal to. Here, observe, students. Total 8. Total 8 means, do the further set. 4 heads taken at a time. Next, 4 tails. Like this. Next, 4 half, 2. 2 heads, 2 tails. 2 heads, 2 tails. Next, 2 half, that is 1. Head, tail. Head, tail. Head, tail, head, and also tail. These are the outcomes to this. Okay? Right. So that is head, head, head. Next, head, head, tail. Next, head, tail, head. Next, head, tail, tail, and then 4 completed. Next, tail, head, head, tail, head, tail, 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 head, tail, tail, tail. Okay, these are the outcome, students. Right, what he has observed. So, Hanif win the matches. Wins if all the tosses give the same results. Hanif wins all the tosses gives the same result. So here we find probability of Hanif will lose the game. So then that implies probability of here same results means 3 heads, 3 tails. Okay, remaining all are possible outcomes. So probability of Hanif will lose the game. Hanif lost the game. Lost the game equal to lost the game. How many chances? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 by 8. Nothing but 3 by 4. This is the solution of given 6th problem, students. Right. Observe 7th problem. Two dice are thrown simultaneously. Find the probability of getting. So first, two dice are tossed thrown simultaneously. Total number of outcomes n of s equal to 36. Okay, so comes to problem number 1. So in that first a doublet, students, doublet means same number. So by using here two of our students, so doublets, how many of them doublets which are 1 1, 2 2, 3 3, 4 4, 5 5, 6 6. So favorable outcomes equal to 6. Total outcomes equal to 36, students. So we have taken here probability of a equal to n of a by n of s. So favorable outcomes equal to 6, total outcomes equal to 36. Strike it off, you can get 1 by 6, students. So do work, students. Let a be the an event getting a doublet, or you can write the information, friends. And comes to second one. But here's a doublet of even numbers. So here this 2, 2, 4, 4, 6, 6 are the even number of doublets. Okay. So let the information here. Let be the event of getting even numbers of doublets. So here n of b equal to 3 only, students. N of b equal to 3. Therefore probability of b equal to n of b by n of s. So it becomes 3 by 36. So strike it off, it becomes 1 by 12. And go for third. What he has? An even number as the sum. So let C be the an even number as the sum. So n of C.